Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 26th of 2019, well, it is titled Da Vinci Rise. So what do we see here? Well, this taken about a month ago, because we are back to about this phase of the moon again. And this is what we call the waning crescent phase, which is the last phase before the new moon. So this is the very old moon, the very edge of it, only that very lower left side towards the bottom is illuminated directly by the sun. So this is the very latest phase, and we see it as it will get thinner and thinner over a day or two, and then we will have new moon, and then we will become back to a crescent again on the other side, where the right hand side would be illuminated. Now this, we see the moon, of course, here, the portion that's illuminated, but that is overexposed. We don't see any detail there. And what we see is the part of the moon that is not being directly illuminated by the sun. So how can the moon be illuminated except by the sun? The sun is really the only source of light in the solar system. That is where all the light comes from. And when we see planets or other objects, we're seeing them by reflected sunlight. However, the moon also shines by reflected earthlight, which is, in essence, sunlight as well. Sunlight strikes the earth and reflects off of the earth and strikes the moon and then comes back to earth. So it does give a low illumination to the moon. Normally, you don't see it very well because the moon is overly bright and the bright portion will dominate and make it harder to see that the other portion is illuminated. However, in this case, with a very thin crescent moon, we can actually see the illumination. And one of the things that we notice is that the features that we see on the moon are exactly the same here as they are during, for example, a full moon. And what that means is that one side of the moon always faces the earth. So we only see the same side. It does not matter what phase it is. It is the same portion of the moon that is always facing the earth. And it wasn't until 1959 that we actually flew around the other side and got our first images of the far side of the moon. Now, this is called the Da Vinci Rise because this was explained as Earthshine by Leonardo da Vinci over 500 years ago. As to the process of Earthshine was, as I explained earlier, was light from the sun that strikes the earth and then bounces to the moon and then bounces back to the earth. So it's an indirect illumination of the moon, nowhere near as bright as the direct illumination by sunlight, but still allows us to see the features of the moon as we do in our image today. So that was our picture of the day for September the 26th of 2019. It was titled Da Vinci Rise. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be annotated GC. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.